The Liberal Party understands that about me, and they're accepting of my views, of my difference of opinion. They see it as a strength.
After leaving the Green Party to join the Liberals, largely over a disagreement about Israel, Jenica Atwin has now backtracked on her comments about Israel, becoming more in line with the Liberal Party line, which already was in line with the Green Party leader's comments that Jenica Atwin had criticized. So it sounds confusing. Don't worry, I'm going to break it down. But I'll be clear here. This is not a complete reversal of Atwin's criticisms of Israel, but it's practically indistinguishable from the Green Party leader's comments that Atwin was critical of. So let me start explaining it all by showing you where it all started. So the Green Party of Canada put out a statement about Israel that was on May 10th. So shortly after the strikes from the and the escalation from the Israeli government on Palestinians, saying the Green Party of Canada calls for an immediate de-escalation in the violence and a return to dialogue as a means to seeking a peaceful solution. Quote, violence and confrontation will not bring resolution, only more suffering. And if you read the full statement, you can pause the video here and read through this. It's essentially saying the same thing. It's both sizing the issue when clearly there is a power imbalance here. The Israeli government, backed by the world's superpowers, bombing a open-air prison of Gaza. Palestinians living there, living essentially in an open-air prison, cannot leave. And anyways, I've discussed at length that issue. I don't want to get too much more into it. But to that, the CJP ME, which is, just to be clear here again, Canadians for Justice and Peace in the Middle East, they criticized the Green Party's statement on this, saying the statement is worse than expected. It does not mention the forced evictions in Sheikh Jarrah. It does not mention Israel's violent assault in Al-Aqsa. It does not mention the children in Gaza murdered in airstrikes. We expect a far higher standard from the Canadian Greens. And at the time, Green Party Member of Parliament Jenica Atwin replied to that, saying it is a totally inadequate statement. Forced evictions must end. I stand with Palestine and condemn the unthinkable airstrikes in Gaza. End apartheid. So here, at the time, I gave Jenica Atwin a lot of credit for putting out the statement, being in direct contrast with the Green Party's official statement and the leader's feelings about the Israeli government. So this was a great statement at the time. And since then, she has backtracked. So before I get to her most recent updated version of her opinion here, I first want to show you what happened. So she crossed the floor late last week to join the Liberal Party. And on Sunday, she had this interview on CTV, and listen to her comments here. Again, this is before she did a complete reversal on Monday.
But look, you have called Israel an apartheid state. Your views are now totally opposed to the party and the government that you've just joined. And your views are probably more at home in the Green Party than in the Liberal Party. Why should people believe you that this was such a, as you say, a massive issue if you joined a party that diametrically oppose your views on what you say is a critical issue?
And that's an extremely fair question. First, I have to say my comments, so it was a Twitter post. I'm also slightly embarrassed to know that a lot of this is precipitated from social media. But I said hashtag end apartheid.
Right.
So basically, it's so that people can educate themselves on what apartheid is, how it operates, how it impacts the people who are oppressed under that system. I'm really very much my approach is in learning and in dialogue and in conversation. And so it's important to know, you know, specifically how I laid out my comments that day.
Just to be fair, you know, when you tweet end apartheid and you say I stand with the Palestinians, you're calling Israel an apartheid state. Are you backing away from that now?
No. I certainly stand by what I'm saying.
Okay.
I'm just like,
so that's
again,
opposed to the liberal
to
position.
Learning.
I'm just saying, you know, you've joined a party that does not believe that at all.
Well, and that's the thing is that I know there's a large caucus and that there is a difference of opinion within the caucus. And I've been told that, you know, they've had, you know, very good, you know, healthy discussion and debate about this. So I know I'm going to a place where I'm not alone in how I feel about this issue. And I think what's going to be, you know, a positive thing for me is that the Liberal Party understands that about me. And they're accepting of my views, of my difference of opinion. They see it as a strength that I can come in and have these difficult conversations. I was very open and honest in my, you know, disclosure about how I feel about TMX, for example, in particular. So now it's just, you know, I said I was going to go hold government to account as a member of Parliament for Fredericton, and I will continue to do that right from the inside.
Jenica Atwin here saying that she will hold the government to account. Her positions have not changed. That's what she loves about the Liberal Party, that they allow her to have those differing positions and have those disagreements and have those discussions. Well, that was Sunday. This is Monday. So almost like a hostage here of the Liberal Party, she puts out this tweet saying, please see my statement, and then puts that in French as well. And then let me read through her new position on Israel. My words regarding the conflict between Palestinians and Israel were intended to send strength and love to people I believe are in need of support. Palestinians are suffering. Israelis are also suffering as well as their loved ones in Canada and around the world. No one wins with war. I regret if my choice of words caused harm to those who are suffering. Anti-Semitism is wrong. Islamophobia and racism are wrong. We all have a responsibility to listen and learn as much as we can and try to help. I am still learning the best ways to offer support for people on the ground. I am thankful to have colleagues of all faiths and beliefs to do my work and to support peace. I am looking forward to sitting down with my new colleagues and stakeholders to continue my learning on this matter and to continue to support a two-state solution. So, this statement is practically indistinguishable from the Green Party's official statement on the matter, which Jenica Atwin criticized. Then was criticized by the Green leader's top advisor over, and then Atwin left because of those criticisms. So, as I discussed in my video of Atwin leaving the Green Party, I fully understand being pissed off at the party leader and the top advisor, the party leader not coming to your defense when her top advisor basically says, we're going to get rid of you. So I understand that. But to claim that you are going to hold the same position, that you are not going to change your criticisms of Israel, that you're going to, your principles are staying the same. But a day later, clearly you have backtracked on your position on Israel. This is typical politician bullshit. And it's sad because I have had hope for someone like Jenica Atwin who was willing to call out their party leader. But if her principles are staying the same, then we should be seeing comments like this directed towards Justin Trudeau, with Jenica Atwin now being a member of the Liberal Party. Do you think we're going to see those criticisms of Trudeau now from Atwin, the way she criticized the Green leader? I don't think so. So this is the whole situation is incredibly sad. And if you look at the reaction to Atwin's comments on Twitter, you can see here 620 replies, only 242 likes. This is what we call a ratio. If you read through the comments, everybody here criticizing Atwin, the vast majority of comments here criticizing her for backtracking on her positions. And it really is sad. We had three Green MPs in Parliament. In case you don't know, I ran as a Green candidate years ago. But I support both the Greens and the NDP. It depends on the riding who is, you know, has a better chance at holding that seat. But if you're in Fredericton and you voted for Atwin, you have to be incredibly disappointed that you thought you were voting for this and instead you got this.